okay, we're headed up this wash. There's a lot of debris here that's washed down. Big timbers, barrels, pieces of sheet metal. Nobody's been up here in probably 50, 60 years. Okay, this looks like remnants of a old ore cart laying here in the wash. It's on its side. There's the upper side, and that's looking into the ore cart. And it looks like the wheels might have been here on the bottom. This might have been a pivoting ore cart. It's hard to tell. But and then here's the inclined shaft. It's supposed to be 700 feet long with drift levels every 100 feet for a total 7,000 feet total of underground workings. Okay, here's a shot zooming down the shaft. Ore cart tracks would come up on the left and the ladders on the right. That's looking down the shaft, zooming in. It's a little sketchy, some collapse down there, but we'll go check it out. Looks like the shaft flattens out towards the bottom there, like a lot of these always do. They kind of go down at an angle, then kind of bottom out. You can see it bottoming out down there. Okay, I'm at the second drift level off the inclined shaft. Looking here to my left, leads into a stoped area. And looking to my right, not too much over there. Okay, this is the second drift level off the inclined shaft. There's an animal that just ran up into here. Jeremy thought it was a raccoon. It ran down this tunnel. There were a lot of good sized droppings right back there at the shaft, so I don't want to corner anything in here. I don't see anything. Unless he went down here to the right, down this pit. Okay, so walking back out towards the inclined shaft right here in front of me from the second drift level. There's a shot looking down into the workings. Okay, continuing down the inclined shaft to the third drift level. Okay, on the third drift level is an ore chute coming down from that stope back up on the second level. You can see the sides of the chute there, and there's the mouth of the chute, and more stoping action behind that. And this is looking down the inclined shaft, and this is looking over at a metal line chute there coming down from the other drift level here at the third level, and that dumped out right here into a waiting ore cart that would stop right there on those inclined tracks, and the ore would dump from that chute right down into it. This is a shot looking back up the inclined shaft from just below the third drift level, and I noticed right here, hard to see, but on the timber here is a name, looks like Stan, 1949, right there. Here's an old ore cart laying in the shaft on its side. It's made out of metal. Okay, here's the other side of that ore cart. You're looking at the bottom here where the wheels would have been. They've been removed. And there's the hinge door that would dump the ore out. And there's the cart in its entirety. There's a wheelbarrow right in the next to this ore cart that's tipped over. Here's a shot of this wheelbarrow from the side. That definitely, by that wheel there in the front, that looks definitely old school. Here's an old newspaper from August of 1925, the Los Angeles Examiner. And right next to that is this old wooden box for Santa Clara prunes. Okay, that's looking down at the, I think we're on the fifth drift level, maybe the sixth, lost track, but looks like the shaft gets a little steeper right beyond there. But anyway, looking up here on the ore cart tracks, or what would have been the ore cart tracks, you can see in that cross section right there, the cross timber, the groove that was worn by the cable that would pull the carts up the tracks. There's the groove that the cable ran through. Here we're headed down the fifth drift level here. Yeah, it looks like at one time there's a lot of water down here. It's a lot of dried mud probably coming down through the shaft. And yeah, I think this is all like been filled in by the mud flowing down in here, the water. Here's an ore chute that says keep out. This side shot of the chute. And here's this retaining wall holding back all that loose rubble. And stepping around to the side. Yeah, you can see all the debris that's collapsed down in there, being held in place by that retaining wall. Okay, this is drift level number 7, I think. Heads off this way. Here's a split tunnel to the left, tunnel to the right. Yeah, one of the earliest dates here on this wall where the miners sign their names is Cliff, 1927, June. Some other names here, Clancy, from 1967, and 1923, 1927, Jimmy, July 27th, 1937. And the tunnel continues this way. Okay, here's this really deep winze. That just goes down there and stops. It's just a pit. There's no tunneling down there. Ore carts would have came up there on the rails. And then there would have been a, here's a head frame, and there would have been a winch back here. And then right here, it looks like this was a pegboard to keep track of the ore carts. They put little pegs in those holes, maybe. All right, Jeremy and Harlan are coming back up. There's nothing down there at the very bottom. It's kind of wet and muddy, so we're all not going to go down there and check it out. Okay, we're looking up the shaft there. You can see daylight. We're about 250 feet down from the surface and making our way back up. Let me zoom in there. And there's our exit. Here's a shot looking down the tailings and then across the ravine. In the distance there, you can see the stone foundation of what was probably a miner's cabin. There's remnants of a collapsed cabin across the wash, and then right here in front of me, some kind of tank for the mill here. A lot of circular pipes in there. And then looking up at tailings, foundations for machinery here at the mill, and there's a distant shot of the whole thing. Here's a partially buried tank near the old mill. It's partially buried in the ground.